अनुसंधान ऑल गुजरात इंटीग्रेटेड क्लासरूम
सैटेलाइट ना माध्यम थी जोड़ती कड़ी एटले संधान।
गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट डिस्कसिंग ऑन बैंकिंग एंड सेक्रेटरियल करस्पॉन्डेंस। टुडे माय नेम इज धीरेन्द्र सुथार। I teach English and CC at AP Patel Arts and NP Patel Commerce College, Naroda. I have been teaching English for the last 15 years. I am happy that I am going to deliver talk on secretarial and banking correspondence under the Sandhan series of lectures of BISEC Studio. Banking correspondence, there is a statement, put your trust in money, but put your money in trust. I repeat, put not your trust in money, but put your money in trust. This is an important identification of bank, that bank is a kind of an institute which is full of trust, and we feel sure that our money is totally safe in the bank. There are various kinds of bank functioning in India: corporate banks, private sector banks, cooperative banks and others. So there are various types of banks working in India. I'd like to tell you one thing, that the first Bank of India was established in 1786, and the name of the first bank we started in India was General Bank of India, which started in 1786. Later on, that bank is known as State Bank of India. The name State Bank of India was given in 1806. Initially, the bank's headquarter and the functioning of bank was in Calcutta. Now, we are going to study various functions of bank. There are basically three functions of bank. First is borrowing. Borrowing can be done in way of various types of deposit. You can have a recurring deposit, fixed deposit, then you will have a debenture, bond. So bank does borrow money from investor. This is the function of the borrowing of the bank. Second function of the bank is lending. Bank lends money to its client, customers or corporates in various ways: overdrafts, loans, cash credit, traveling check, credit card or debit card. There are various ways of lending. You can also add cash credit facility, and so on and so forth. Third function of bank is miscellaneous. In this category, we can include demand drafts, collection of checks, locker facility, mutual fund, insurance, demat, etc. Banks provide us various facilities under the title miscellaneous. Issue of demand drafts, various kinds of checks, locker facility. They also deal in selling of gold and other insurance business also. Nowadays they are also engaged in issuing and operating demat facilities to the demat holders. So this is the third function of miscellaneous of the bank. Bank also provides various facility like ATM, credit card facility or debit card facility, demat account, e-banking, electronic banking, net banking, phone banking, mobile banking. So this is a latest version of bank where we don't see traditional functioning or running of the business of bank, but it is a kind of business which is done very fastly. Now we come into the segment which is very important to us as far as appearing in examination is concerned and getting good marks is concerned. In our examination, there are two functions of two various correspondence which are very important as far as getting marks are concerned. One is banking correspondence, where you will have one question along with internal options, wherein you are supposed to answer in one question, and you will get around 14 marks of the question for banking correspondence. So when we are asked to write a letter in for banking correspondence, we are to give our information why we write a letter. First of all, we have to mention our bank account number of the bank where we are going to transact or communicate. Secondly, we have to mention the purpose behind writing the bank letter. Why do we write letter? Because we want someone or banker to do something for you. Third thing is we write letter to boost the relationship, create strength and goodwill with the bank. So this is the third reason why we write letter with the bank or to the bank. When it comes about qualities of the bank, there are five various features that we should try to the mind, try to follow these five basic qualities while writing banking letters. It should be correct one. Second, it should not be abrupt one, it should be clear. Third one is courtesy. We should not try to become rude as a customer. We should try to be polite and write with formal language, and we should not get irritated when we get delayed reply from the bank. We should strict to adhere to courtesy in all our banking letters. Fourth is conciseness. See that we live in 21st century and it's modern era where people do not have a lot of time to spare and read essay like letters. So letters of any communication should be concise one. It should neither be too short nor too long. It should be concise one of moderate length. And we should try to avoid repetition of each and every paragraph. There should not be a repetition. Last quality of bank letter is naturalness. It should flow like a water. It should not look artificial one. It should be perfectly unique one. So these are the five qualities. I request all my students to follow these qualities in order to enhance your correspondence. There are 10 types of bank letters in our syllabus. First is stop payment object. Second is error in passbook. Third one is wrongful dishonor of check. Fourth is complaint of rude behavior of bank employee. Fifth is asking for annual report for housing loan. These are the letters which are in our syllabus and important letters of banking correspondence. Remaining letters are requesting banks support for social welfare. Suppose if there arises a misfortune or catastrophe like flood, earthquake or war, you want bank to extend a kind of helping hand towards that good cause for the society, you can write a letter requesting banks to support for national cause or social welfare. Seventh number letter is error in demat statement. Suppose you have sold 100 shares of any company that you purchased, but when you receive the statement from the bank, it appears that there is a mistake, and instead of 100, 1000 shares of particular company are debited into your account. So you will have a chance, because you have found an error in the demat statement, so that you are supposed to write a letter to the bank pointing out error in demat statement. Next one is non-credit of sales in demat account. Next, second last is transfer of demat shares. And the last one is intimating the loss of debit card. Dear students, we have one-way communication with the bank. Only 10 letters on the part of customers and client are in a syllabus. So whenever we try to communicate with the bank, banking correspondence, customers' letters are important as far as our exam is concerned, and we are going to follow customer's letter. And these letters are important, and in banking correspondence we have one-way communication. Let's take up two or three examples related to the banking correspondence. Suppose you have received passbook and you have found an error as far as the entry of the entry in your account is concerned. Suppose it is debit or credit, so you want to raise this question with the bank. So what points you should kept in mind while writing a letter with the bank? First of all, nowadays bank issues customer ID, so you can write your customer ID. Suppose you have saving bank's account, you can write your saving bank account number, or you can write current bank account number, or any other account that you have with the bank. When writing a letter, when you try to show the mistake of the bank, you should be polite in pointing out clearly an error in passbook, whether it is entries, one or two entry, or more than three entries. So you should be very polite. Make a request to get an error rectified. So this is the last point that you should mention. You have to make request to bank when you wish to get your error rectified. See that there is a very good statement: to err is human and to forgive is divine. We should not be ruthless, we should be polite in communicating with a bank. This is the second example that we are going to take. Suppose you have been using a bank and you have taken a loan from the bank and you want bank to issue annual report for housing loan for the particular annual year. Say for instance annual year 2013-14. So when you write a letter for annual statement, you want your annual statement or report issued on your name or will be dispatched to you at your address. You can ask for a soft copy also, and that soft copy will be sent to you in your email ID. So there are other ways through which we can also ask bank to send you annual report apart from writing letter and and getting it. So this is the traditional way of communication, to write a letter to bank and get it posted, and bank will receive the letter and answer you later. But see that you can use email in all kind of correspondence, and this is a very fast way of communicating with the bank, and bank will send you soft copy at your address, email address. When you have to face such a situation, you want your home loan statement to be issued, these points you should try to keep in your mind. Do mention customer ID, file number, housing loan number. Second is be polite in directing your bank to issue annual report for housing loan. You have to provide reason why you want. Say for instance you want to submit it to your employee, or you want to use it to your with income tax department, or any other reason that you have. Today we are going to see one or two sample letters that I have for you. We are going to see sample